So now we're going to look at the skull from the inferior point of view. You can see here the maxilla, and you can see here the palatine bone. This over here is the sphenoid bone, and we have the temporal bones on the sides and the occipital bone right here. This is the mandible that I explained in my previous video. Since this is the sphenoid bone, here you have the pterygoid plates, and this is the medial pterygoid plate, and you have the lateral pterygoid plate as well. On the temporal bone, you have the mastoid process, and you have the styloid process. You also have the temporal bone on the other side. Now let's cut to the interesting part, the foramen. Here we have the incisive foramen. And on the palatine bone, we have the greater foramen of the palatine bone, and possibly two lesser foramen, but sometimes only one. Now here we have the foramen ovale and the foramen spinosum. You can also find the foramen lacerum here, and the jugular foramen here. This here is the occipital condyle, and this here as well. And this is the articulating surface with the atlas. So no wonder that this canal here is called the condylar canal. Now, because this is the mastoid process of the temporal bone, and this is the... Now, because this is the styloid process, and this here is the mastoid process of the temporal bone, then it's no wonder that this foramen here is called the styloid-mastoid foramen. Now let's look at the skull from the inside. This over here is the anterior cranial fossa, while this is the middle cranial fossa. And this over here is the posterior cranial fossa. Now the anterior cranial fossa is created by this big bone here, the frontal bone. Now what you can see here is basically the roof of the orbita when you look at it from here. But let's get back to the bone and look at it from here. This is the ethmoid bone, and you can see these little holes here, and those holes are on the cribriform plate of the ethmoid bone. Through these holes you have these nerves passing and carrying the signals of sense, going to the olfactory nerve and going to the brain. This here is the Crista Galli, where the falx cerebri attaches. Now let's zoom out and let's explain the foramina that can be seen from the inside. Well, basically I want you to know that... So this here is the optic canal, and it is here that you can see the superior orbital fissure. Now I have explained these structures in my previous video when I have explained the face and the skull from the anterior point of view. Here is the superior fissure, and here you have the canal. This here is the inferior orbital fissure. But let's get back to our point of view again. So here you have the foramen ovale, and this would be the foramen spinosum. This here is the foramen lacerum, and you're able to see these foramina from the outside as well. Here you can see the jugular foramen, and here you can see the internal artery meatus. This here would be the foramen magnum, and this here is the hypoglossal canal. And if we look at it from here, well, there should be a small canal here, and that's called the condylar canal. I think the position is not 100% exact, but it's really hard to model these things to be completely correct. Now let's look at this part right here. We have here two clinoid processes, and we also have the posterior clinoid processes. Between them is actually the sella turcica, which got its name as a Turkish saddle. Now it really does look like a saddle. But why Turkish? I have no idea either. Now the place here in the saddle is called the pituitary fossa. And it's called pituitary fossa because that's where the pituitary gland is located.